Sleeping Buckers, how are you guys doing? You guys good? Yeah. Recruiters, hello. Property people. Hello. Are you guys really in property? Yeah. You're the earth, right? Alright, cool man. My name is... Okay, what? Alright, cool. My name is Tata, guys. So I see you guys don't are not religious at all. Everyone else is in Moria. Drinking oil-based tea. And you guys are like, we want tequila, damn it. That's awesome, I love that. I'm saying if you guys want to buy me a shot of tequila, I'll gladly take it. And I'll even do a selfie with you. I mean, just saying. Instant photos. Yeah, talking about selfies though, guys, I love selfies. I take selfies almost every single minute, okay, every Sunday. I own like 5 selfie sticks, it's ridiculous. But what I don't like though is the technology of cameras these days. When I take a selfie with my white friends, it's a selfie of her and a silhouette of me. Because I don't think the devs have worked on our skin color. And then this is perpetuated black people bleaching their skin. This is shit. Okay? Any devs in the house tonight? Any developers? Designers? Fix that shit. It's crap. Yeah, guys, I'm a badass. I used to be a criminal. I was actually kicked out of church when I was 6 years old because I stole a bike. Anyway, long story. So guys, recently I actually ran across the Atlantic Ocean. I don't want to get claps for that, but you guys are fine to be seriously, I don't. So guys, before I got to go to run across the ocean, I had to do a sea survival course. Yeah? In case, you know, our boat sinks, we have to know what to do. So I phoned around, obviously they don't have them in Joburg or Pretoria, so I phoned around in Durban, found nothing. And I phoned around in Cape Town, found nothing. And eventually I got through to a place called the Cape Town Peninsula University of Technology, also known as Kaput. So I was doing my sea survival course in an establishment called Kaput. That was interesting times. Guys, when I phoned in, I literally thought I was through tuition being because the lady was so loud, like really loud. So this is how the conversation went. I phoned in, I said, hello, and she's like, hello! I'm like, whoa, that's a bit loud. And I'm like, hello, my name is Tata. I'd like to find out when your next sea survival course is. And she was like, which one? We have the PSTQ and the PSSR. And I'm like, ma'am, I'm not really familiar with your codes, but let me give you a brief. I'm rowing across the ocean. And she was like, you are doing what? And I'm like, I'm rowing across the ocean. You are rowing? And I'm like, yes, ma'am. She's like, you, Betuna? I'm not a fan of sharks. And I'm like, no ma'am, I'm a storm supporter, so I think I'll be fine. And she wasn't, right? and then she said to me, okay, the course is going to start on the 18th of November. You must be here, go 3. I'm like, oh, sorry? You must be here, go 3 o'clock. I'm like, oh, okay, I'll be there. Thank you. And that's what I discovered, guys. Black people are really chilled about a lot of things, you know, rowing across the ocean, be here, 3 type of thing. When I spoke to my white friends, it was a completely different story altogether. Like, you guys are like detectives. White people, you guys are hitting. So same statement, I'm like, guys, they swapped and rowing across the Atlantic Ocean. They were like, wow. You know, high five, 35 type of thing. And then I got hit with this passive aggressive question of, how did you get involved in that? And I said, BEE. Quota system, you know what I'm saying? And then they stopped with the question, they were like, can you actually swim? No. But I am hoping to learn the black stroke when I get to the ocean. Do you guys know what the black stroke is? Do you guys know what the black stroke is? No one knows. The black people over there, do you know what the black stroke is? No, okay, I'll show you. This is the black stroke. You will drown. Seriously, guys. So I learned the black stroke. I'm an exceptional black stroker. So when we were in the ocean, guys, we were hit by waves, right? Waves as high as Buttermilk and Lemonis Bar Time. They were just like sky high. And when the waves hit us, we did that. the black shirt. So guys, we actually wrote for charity. So we wrote from Spain to Barbados for ECD. Yeah, and nobody in the booth. Thank you. They should really like that. So nobody in the booth on the crew thought of bringing any board games because, you know, we thought we were gonna die. So we didn't bring any board games whatsoever because there's only so many times you can play the game. I spy with my little eye something beginning with W, water, which Cape Town doesn't have. But anyway, so I've been playing with an app, guys. I've been playing with an app. Her name is Siri. I'm sure you guys are familiar with her. So I asked her this mathematical question. I said to her, Siri, what is 0 divided by 0? And then she said to me, imagine that we have 0 cookies that we have to divide among 0 friends. How many cookies would each friend get? So I started counting. And she's like, the cookie monster is upset because there are no cookies. And you're sad because you've got no friends. Bitch. Yeah? She's horrible. So I decided to get her back. I asked her a controversial question. And a question I'm willing to bet everyone in this room wants to know the answer to. I know he's no longer our president. But anyway, so I asked her, I said, Siri, how much did Jacob Zimmer's give away? Because you know it's got the labels, right? Like a double decker bus, but an empty one. Because all the passengers were off. Fuck this shit. You're kidding me, right? So she didn't want to answer the question, so I threatened her. I'm like, Siri, would you like to go for a swim? So she panicked. So remember she had this robotics American accent. And when she spoke to me, she had this deep South African male accent. And she said to me, it weighs. I'm like, Siri, what's wrong with you? What's wrong with your voice? And she said, listen properly. It weighs 939,000 and 60,000. Or close to 1,000,000. Thank you very much, guys. My name is Tati.